through the McIntyre School of Music, and my very good friends, Dr. Fang and Fang, I've known for 20 years now. Yeah, thank you. So we're doing gamelan for the last two pieces and for this piece. And gamelan is an orchestra of instruments that come from Indonesia. Specifically, two regions in Indonesia that we sort of think about in the West are Balinese gamelan and Javanese gamelan from the islands of Bali and Java. There's also Sundanese and a few other different local varieties, but those are sort of the big ones for us in the West. So the first piece that you heard, the vocal piece, was a presentation of something called Kecak, which is a Balinese piece of music. It's the Balinese monkey chant from the Ramayana epic. And that is sort of descriptive of, it shows the style of koteken, which is sort of a texture used in Balinese music, where they have interlocking rhythms. So if you think about rhythms being cycles of numbers, if you have three things that you have to do, a few people will take notes one and two, and a few people will take notes two and three, and a few people will take notes one and three. And between all of them, they cover all three notes, but they can go for much faster speeds, even though they only have to do two of the three notes for any one individual. So it allows them to do incredibly fast things. We also, this last piece was, it's called Budan Mas, and I don't want to belabor the point, but I think it's helpful to understand, because these instruments are not from Indonesia, these instruments are from Central California. So I think it's helpful to know sort of what they're doing. In Javanese gamelan, which is sort of a slower, more deliberative style of gamelan playing, let me start with this. The title of the piece is Budan Mas, which means golden ring, but the longer title for the piece is Bubar Budan Mas Lar Sandra Patet Manura, as a mouthful. But it all means something. I think it's helpful for understanding the style of music that we're playing. So Bubar is the form of the tune. It's a 64-beat melody, and the internal melody is called the Balungan. And so they basically all memorized the Balungan. They memorized it basically before I came. And that's important because you don't play the Balungan for the whole time. And in fact, with the piece that we just played, much of what they were doing was realized, kind of improvised, starting on, was it Friday or was it supposed to be on Saturday? Yeah, there are rules surrounding sort of the realization of this part. So they basically all learn some of the guidelines and we learn to realize it over the course of the weekend. So they're not actually playing whatever's on their written page in front of them. They're playing improvisatory rules, what the Balinese might call, or what the Javanese might call flowers out of the original melody. The part after Udan Mas, so Bubar Udan Mas, the other parts have to do with the scale. So in Indonesian music, there are basically two scales. There's a 5-tone scale called Slendro, and a 7-tone scale called Pela. And in most Javanese gamelans, they'll have one keyboard, or a set of bonons, or whatever, for each scale, and they'll just leave it be. But this was sort of an innovation of this gentleman named Dan Schmidt in California in the 80s, where he had interchangeable pitches between Slendro and Pela, and he decided to make it so that you could play either scale out of one keyboard. So instead of having 12 keyboards, I own 6, and you can just switch the notes out. And so that's helpful. So that is Lara Slendro, and then the Patet is like a mode within the scale. So you can see already, like thinking about just the title, that the sort of logical layout of this, all of the 64 notes, that number should be familiar to anyone who owns a computer, because it's all sort of nested, you know, nested amounts of two, right? It can be easily divisible by two, and then divisible by two again, and divisible by two again. And so the gong part for the Javanese stuff all ends up being sort of in these nesting cycles. It's called kalata, okay? So the piece that you're about to hear, I think that's the reason it's important to explain that, because the piece that you're about to hear that I composed uses both Balinese and Javanese sort of idiomatic writing, and then it also uses idiomatic drum set writing as opposed to a very sort of virtuosic sort of bunch of notes on the drum set. I tried to write idiomatic parts for all the instruments and sort of interchange them as much as we possibly could. So anyway, it's a lot of talking. Excuse me, I wanted to give them time to change notes over. So we're going to play my piece, Lanchester's Law, and thank you again, everybody, for coming out tonight. There's a second half of the concert. There's four more pieces after we clear the stage, so please stick around after a short.
Thank you. Thank you. to actually have a dress rehearsal with a gamelan instrument, we had to be at a weekday, so we can use the hall last night. So that's why it's on a weekday. But next year, we'll be back on the weekend. So as every year when we do this concert, I'm really grateful for our students. They work very, very hard, and they are just great human and wonderful students. And every year I have some people graduating. Last year I had 11. So I actually totally cried on the stage and live stream, you know. So, but this year we only have 3, and they are actually going to be featured in a way in the next piece. Our next piece was written for us to celebrate our ensemble's 10th anniversary. And next year we are celebrating our 20th. So so this piece was written in nine years ago, and has the element of gamelan in it as well, because it was my teacher dedicated the piece to me, and it's like my 10 years in Charlottesville, my step walking to the Charlottesville, and I also went to Bali and studied gamelan with him. So that's why there's an element of gamelan in this next piece that you're going to hear. And for the vibraphone, they are going to do the koteken, like what you hear on the instrument over here, the demon and sarong. So they are going to imitate that technique, but on vibraphone. And so it's a feature two of our graduating fourth year. We are moving around, but so Jack will be on the silver Yamaha vibraphone, and Edward will be on the master gold vibraphone. And I'm just going to say a little bit about each of them, and then Kunz is going to start the piece, and Kunz is also graduating, and he's going to be on marimba one. So Kunz will be graduating as a computer science major and going into the industry as a data scientist. And Kunz actually is finishing up within just 3 years. So, Kunz, right here. Setting up, but Edward, he is a computer science major as well, and he's going to work in Chicago as a quantitative trader at Optiver. And a fun fact about Edward is he actually was qualified for the world finals for the collegiate programming contest. So basically the collegiate league for coding. And he was supposed to go to Egypt in November, but you know the situation, so he couldn't go. But he was qualified for the finals. And we have Jack. Woo! Originally from Utah, but then he moved to Charlottesville with his parents. And he's actually biochemistry and music major, and he's doing DMP distinguished major project for both majors. And he's also in performance concentration. So he just finished his solo recital in February. And his plans is working as a lab specialist in a cancer lab at UVA while applying to MD PhD dual degree program around cancer.